I'm Curt Dudley here in the broadcast booth, and joining me here today is Kevin Warner, Athletics Director for Athletics Communication. He's actually my boss when it comes down to it. But he keeps a really close eye between Kevin and Chris Brooks, the Sports Information Director for football here. These guys, they chew it up quite a bit. And so we asked Kevin to come in and kind of give us a feel for what the national scene looks like. And Kevin, we're going to start with, I guess, some projections on who the eight seeds might be when the committee announces it in a couple of weeks.
I think that's what JMU Nation really wants to know right now. What are those seeds going to look like? Last year, the Dukes were kind of that one team out that missed on the seed picture. Certainly, the thing's looking good for JMU right now, especially with the big lead at the half against Richmond. If JMU seals this win today, I think Dukes can pretty much expect to be a seed. So let's take a look at how the seeds stand right now. And again, this is how I see things, and I bat this around with Chris Brooks. North Dakota State and James Madison, I think, are a pretty solid 1-2 right now. They've really separated themselves from the pack. And perhaps even more so, I think a lot of fans have been watching Weber State. Weber State actually down big at the half right now, 21-3 at Montana. So those spots may flip if that holds today. Montana may move up to the 3, and that may send Weber State down to the 5 or 6 line. Big Sky looking good for 3 seeds right now, the 3-way tie potentially after today. Northern Iowa with a big game against South Dakota State right now. South Dakota State actually leads that in the third quarter. So I would say the Missouri Valley also looking good for 3 seeds. The winner of that game and Illinois State eked out a win today. Furman may drop out, actually. Furman lost to Wofford today.
Oh, did they?
So okay. Central Connecticut State could move in there. Let's take a look at the automatic qualifiers. 24 teams make the FCS playoffs, and 10 of those are automatic winners of their conferences. So currently we have Weber State in there out of the Big Sky. That may be Montana. I'm not sure the tiebreaker there. Monmouth did win today and I think clinched the automatic qualifier. And James Madison will clinch the AQ with a win today for the CAA. North Dakota State also in good shape. They're up big in the first half. Central Connecticut State earned the automatic qualifier today, beating Robert Morris. That was a first place showdown. Austin Peay also in good shape, though. Southeast Missouri may take that one. That's a close one there in the Ohio Valley. Lafayette lost today, so that actually is going to be Holy Cross. We didn't update our graphics from scores today. But Holy Cross looking good in the Patriot. San Diego almost certainly will win the Pioneer. Furman lost, as we said, so Wofford may move in and take that one for the SoCon. And Southeast Louisiana, the Southland is a mess. Very, very crowded at the top of the Southland. But Southeast Louisiana in good shape there.
Like you say, that's a mess. It can get to be a mess. So let's go to the mess graphic, okay? Because there you've got the projected or maybe at-large bids, and this certainly can be quite the jumble.
Yeah, at-large. I think Montana, Sacramento State almost surely will get in. Montana State in pretty good shape, but that's a big game next week against Montana State. But a big game today for Montana State against UC Davis as well. Kennesaw State won today. I think they'll get that second bid out of the Big South. Albany got a big win against New Hampshire today, so Albany actually in pretty good shape. I like these seeds for the CAA right now, Albany, Villanova, and Towson. Maine maybe with a chance to slip in. They eked out a win against Rhode Island coming from behind. Northern Iowa almost certainly will get in with South Dakota State. Again, they're playing today. Illinois State should be in good shape. Southern Illinois has a big game next week hosting North Dakota State. That's the last test for the Bison, but Southern Illinois may need that game to be the 5th seed out of the Missouri Valley. Wofford, again, in great shape with their win today. Central Arkansas, a big loss last week, so we'll see what that does for them, and Nichols as well. There in the bubble, you see we talked about Maine, Southeast Missouri in good shape. Sam Houston State lost today. I think that'll probably knock them out. And North Dakota, the kind of the hot team people are talking about, an independent. Could an independent get in? They have good wins, but they have some bad losses too.
Okay, now also what we'll learn, of course, is the entire field next Sunday, a week from tomorrow, after the regular season comes to a close. Now for JMU fans, you can already start planning to come to some ball games, Kevin, and you can go online, you can purchase tickets at this stage for the playoffs.
Absolutely. Tickets are on sale already. There's information, I should say, on JMUsports.com and on JMUtickets.com. Season ticket holders can learn prices and deadlines to make their reservations.
Okay, so reservations can be made at this particular point. So things are looking good for the Dukes on the scoreboard and for the playoffs. We'll be back with more of our halftime after this timeout.